Like the wolf. When you say it out loud and think about it, it's such a weird name for the song, isn't it? Hungry like the wolf. It's like Alan Partridge in it. The lockdown has definitely changed the way we live day to day, with many work and social events going digital, and that's no different from music lessons. But these aren't just any music lessons. You project is being rolled out across schools in the Northwest, giving the opportunity to learn and perform popular songs with the experts. It's coming to the Edge Theatre in Charlton for 2 weeks in August, and it's going to be run by drummer Chris Huff, who joins us now. Good morning, Chris.
Morning, Justin. How are you?
I'm all right. You, Chris Huff, should have been on tour with the Lightning Seeds this summer. Is that right?
Yeah, I was tour managing the Lightning Seeds for most of the summer. Obviously, it was Glastonbury this weekend.
Yeah.
The guys were there. And then I had lots of support with my band, The Slow Show.
Yeah.
With The Pixies.
The Pixies? You're going to be on... Oh! And do you know what, Chris? I mean, you know, everybody's got their own cross to bear and everybody's struggling a little bit in different ways. But instead of being on tour with The Pixies, you're going to be in the classroom.
Yeah, well... Just before lockdown, we, you know, me and my partner Chris, we sort of decided that we'll try and go into schools and do some music. So we've been working all the way through,
right,
since March, working with kids in a school in Mossside, Webster in Mossside.
Yep.
And then we thought, what we're going to do for summer? Because we're both musicians, we're both usually busy all summer.
Yeah, yeah.
And we thought, let's roll out what we've been doing in lockdown,
mm-hmm,
in Charlton.
So, tell us about the We Will Rock You project then. What does it do?
So, basically, we try to get young musicians to play a bit of everything. They learn every sort of instrument in a rock band. We have full sort of 10-piece rock bands with singers. They learn songs, sort of old songs and new songs that they know. And we get them just playing and performing, really. We also do some mindfulness. Chris, who's here. Say hello, Chris.
Hi, Justin. You all right, mate?
All right, Chris. Morning.
Two Chrises.
Two Chrises.
We're still together today, hence why I'm here also.
All right.
Yeah, so Chris does mindfulness as well,
mm-hmm,
and he goes around schools doing that. So part of the course is doing a bit of that, which we think is really important, obviously, for kids at the moment with what's been happening.
Yes.
And we're also going to do a bit of art. We've got someone coming in doing a bit of art with them to design album sleeves and load band logos and things.
So it's the whole business then of rock and roll then. What do they do when they... So how long are they with you? Are they with you for a week?
Yeah, Monday to Friday, 9 till 3 every day.
Yeah,
we're going to do, you know, rock bands, learn acoustic guitar, learning samba. We're going to do some samba drumming.
I think we might stream a live little show at the end of the week as well, for obviously parents and people to be able to watch online and see what they've.
Yeah, because normally this sort of thing, you'd put a little show on at the end, but obviously with social distancing, that's going to be slightly different, isn't it?
Yeah, so we're gonna film it. We've got the Edge Theatre,
yeah,
in Charlton. So we're gonna use the theatre at the end to film it all and make it feel like a proper performance. Maybe we could do what United did the other night and put some faces out in the audience.
Yeah, yeah, maybe some atmosphere. Yeah, just take some atmosphere over it as well. Maybe I reckon as well with the kids coming, because obviously they're gonna be having lunch with you. They shouldn't come with lunch. They should have a rider. You know, like,
yeah,
they're properly in a band now. They should do the whole rock and roll experience.
Yeah, yeah. But none of the smashing up the dressing room, though.
No, don't be doing that, because it's a charitable trust, isn't it? They haven't got the money to do that.
Yeah, we can't afford that. Yeah.
We teach that in lesson 7.
Lesson 7, yeah. So how many kids are you going to take? Obviously, the numbers are limited, are they?
Yeah, we were limiting it to 20 and years... ages 7 to 12, but we've had so many inquiries for ages 5 and 6, the siblings of the older children,
yep,
that we've taken another guy, musician friend of ours who works with us, and he's going to take those The younger group, he's worked a lot with the younger children.
Yeah.
So we've got approximately 30 to 35 places now,
mm-hmm.
And that's given us plenty of space in. You know, we've got to think about all the cleaning and aspects in between when we're swapping instruments. So luckily the edge is a big enough space.
Yeah.
The kids will be able to get lunch there if they want it. They're going to open the cafe for those 2 weeks for us.
Good stuff.
Yeah.
All right, so how do we do it then, Chris? How do people sign up?
If they go to the website, www.wewillrockyouproject.com,
yeah.
They'll get all the info on there, and then we'll just keep them updated, send them emails.
Smash it.
And it's the week of the 17th of August, 2 weeks from the 17th of August.
Smash him. Well, look after yourselves. It sounds like it's a great bit of fun. Obviously, lots of parents for school holidays will have to go and work, so they are looking for things to do them. And obviously, not all the options are open, and some of them might not be able to spend time with grandparents. So that's something else as well, isn't it? Join the rock school, and also you'll look after your kids. Thanks, Chris and Chris.
Well, mate.
Nice. Cheers, Justin. I'll see you soon. Take care, mate.
See you soon. We Will Rock Your Project, then. Have a look for that online. If your kids fancy that, and you never know, in 20 years' time, the BBC Philharmonic could be doing one of their songs.